Michael, you almost threatened to spoil the party there at some stages.
Yeah, we couldn't have that, couldn't we? So is that okay? Now, I think that excellent second half. First half, they were the better team, expected, when you play Man United at Old Trafford. I think we're a little lucky only to be 1-0. They could have scored one more, I think. Second half, we came out, scored the equaliser, and were the better team. We had a couple of huge chances. Wayne Routledge had the 2-1 in his feet, and I think it was a very, very good half, second half for us. But unfortunately, the last couple of minutes, another set piece, a thing that has been our weak point this season. If we have to talk about weak points, we conceded too many goals and set pieces today, two more. So, but I think great second half, and looking at the other results, we are 100% sure of ending in the top 10. And things has to go very, very bad for us not to be at least ninth, and we even have possibility, if Man United is doing us a favour against West Brom last game and we win, we could even be eighth, which was, for us would be like winning the championship, because eight is the maximum for us looking at the seven above us. So yeah, we'll probably end up first or second in our league, and that's looking, plus the cup we won this season, amazing season for us.
That sets the benchmark. How do you take this squad on next season?
Yeah, that's a problem, isn't it? How can you do better than this? It's nearly impossible. No, I think you always have to try to find a mark. And I think the mark for this club, this, which is the club with the lowest budget in the Premier League, is to try to consolidate us in the mid-table. I know it sounds a little arrogant, with the lowest budget, and you want to go and to consolidate in the mid-table. But now it's two first season in the Premier, 11th last year, 8th or 9th this season. I think that's what we have to try to aim for next season as well. And it won't be easy, because I know some of the clubs below us, they really want to spend heavily in the summer to do better than they have done this season. So another huge challenge for Swansea City next season.
And as a fellow manager, quietly relieved in a way to see the back of Sir Alex?
Excuse me?
As a fellow manager, is there a hint of relief that Sir Alex is retiring?
No, I think it's an honour for me to be here. I mean, managers, players, they come and go, but not 26 or 27 years. I mean, we're talking about something very, very special in football. Not only football here, football in general. Absolutely amazing. I don't even remember Man United with another manager. So I think it's incredible. And as I said, an honour for me to be here in his last game at home.
How inspirational a character is he for you?
Well, it depends from what point you look at it. If you look at it from the point that how a manager can go on and on and on and on, year after year after year, with that desire to win, then it's a huge thing for me as well, inspiration. And really, I think that's one of the things. And as well, the other thing, to always to think about the present and the future as well. I think that's important in football. You think about the team you have today, but you already have to think about the team tomorrow, for next season, or 6 months, or 12 months. And I always try to do that, and he's been so successful with that. But if you talk about inspiration to be a manager for 27 years in the same club, or only 27 years, then no thank you.
Michael, you talked about winning your own mini league, as it were, but
Well, next season I want to try to consolidate Swansea. There's a lot of challenge there. We're playing in Europe, hopefully. Now, because of Wigan won yesterday, we come in a little earlier. But still, we would like to have that experience as well, as a club, as a team. And I want to be a part of that. And then let's see what happens in the future.
You must take a lot of satisfaction, Michael, because you talked about getting in the top 10 for so long and now you've done it.
Yeah. I mean, it's really amazing, it's, say, this season, because two things. The cup, this season will always be remembered for the cup, because it's the first cup that the Swansea ever won, a major trophy. But to be in the top 10, that's something really, really great again. Money is not all, not in life, not in football, but it's quite important. And to have the lowest budget and to be there, I think that's maybe even a bigger result than winning the cup.
Is that a tribute to your players? That they've done?
Of course. Yeah, I know. But the problem is that we have a philosophy in the club with salaries and all that, so we can't really compete. It's very difficult for us to compete with. We have to do it in our way. We've done it, I think, quite well this season, bringing in some players before some of the others. They got aware of them, so that's what we have to do again. Because if we have to compete with the others, we have no chance.
Did you speak to Sir Alex after the game?
No, I spoke to him before the game, and after the game, just wish him once more best of luck for the future and congratulations with the title.
Michael, Paul Scholes retired as well.
I think it's one of those players that's so important. He's never been one of the ones. He has had his headlines. Don't misunderstand me, but he's never been a guy, you know, in the headlines because he said something or did something. But he's players like that in that position. They're so important because they're the ones who move the tempo of the game, you can say, playing with one touch, with two touches, short passing, long pass. They are so important for me. We all know that, yeah, the goal scorers, they are important. The guys do the special things up just outside the box. The strong defenders are fantastic goalkeeper. But for me, that midfielder there who is always keeping the game moving, that's very, very important for our team. And he's been a great, great player for many years in that position.
When you look at that United squad on the podium, change of manager, obviously, are they still the team to beat next season?
Well, the champions are always the team to beat. At least I remember it like that. So it is. Of course, it would be a new world from the 1st of July. It can't be different, because when you change a manager after so many years, used to doing things in one way, suddenly the new manager is coming in with his ways of doing things. We all different, you know, so everybody will have to get used. The new manager, the staff, the players, everybody, you have to get used to that it's a new manager with new things coming in.
Thank you.